is ablue. Shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. It's a beautiful day.
Just a Thank you. Please be seated. On behalf of these two very precious souls, welcome. Welcome to this great event, this joyful celebration. By being here, enveloped by the Spirit of God, you are all family. A very important network, very important collection, and it's important that you realize the significance of your presence. What you're about to see is not only the commitment of two very precious people, but also God Himself being present and acting to give us something over which we can justifiably be very, very joyful. Dearly beloved, friends and family, we are gathered together in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which holy estate is to be entered into reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God, but also with great and deep joy. Heather, is it your expressed desire to and will to have Barry wedded to you so that you both may live together after God's will and in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him in sickness and in health, and keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Barry, is it your expressed desire and will to have Heather wedded to you so that you may live together after God's will in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, and honor her in sickness and in health, and keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I do.
Over here, so you both look at each other. Grace and peace to you all in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We stand here today at the threshold to the sea. The sea and all its power. Perhaps some of you have experienced the power of the sea, this enormous power. We look to the horizon and can easily imagine the adventure and trials of sailing across such a vast sea. We can imagine the allure of the sea that is captured so well in John Masefield's poem Sea Fever, in which he writes, I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea in the sky, and all I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer her by. And the wheels kick, and the wind's song, and the white sails shaking, and a gray mist on the sea's face, and a gray dawn breaking. This verse is an apt expression of one who is married to the sea. And I know from personal experience that marriage to the seafaring life is something very real. I must go down to the seas again. Soulmates know this feeling. They are drawn to each other. And apart from each other, whether they realize it or not, they are lonely. The lonely sea and the sky. And all I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer her by. For soulmates, the tall ship is the vessel of their marriage. The star to steer her by is God's sanction, blessing, and guidance. The wheels kick, and the wind's song, and the white sails shaking, are the adventures, trials, beauty, joy, and sadness that they will experience in their marriage vessel. As we know, bright sunny days often begin with a gray mist on the sea's face, a mist that serves to shroud the future in mystery, that fills us with a sense of expectation and wonder and awe at what awaits us over the horizon towards which we sail, towards which the soulmates sail in their marriage vessel. So this threshold to the sea is also an apt place here and now to experience and cross another threshold, the threshold to the marriage of two very precious souls, two very precious soulmates, Harry, Heather and Barry. Soulmates who have been drawn to each other. And together they're being drawn to their marriage vessel. They now stand on this shoreline of a powerful sea, which itself is an excellent metaphor and symbol for love. More precisely, for the love of God. Christ-like love, or in the Greek, agape. Agape love is the love of Christ, and it is the substance that binds two souls together in holy matrimony. Agape love is the only thing that can withstand all trials and difficulties to keep a marriage alive. We know this from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, where he is teaching them about agape love. He writes, "Love knows no limit to its endurance, no end to its trust, no fading of its hope. It can outlast anything. It is, in fact, the one thing that still stands when all else has fallen." The only way to receive this love, this powerful love, is to not try to hold on to it or to own it. You can only receive it if you give it away freely, when it flows through you. God will give you power and virtue you cannot obtain on your own, by your own strength. He will give you life. Christ says in the Gospel of John, "I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly." This commitment by Christ has been met in many ways, but most importantly, most particularly, in marriage. In marriage, Heather and Barry, you are able to receive God's agape love and life, and to have these more abundantly than you can imagine. Indeed, they are God's wedding gift to you. And He gives them to you because He knows your innate need to love and be loved. And He wants to give you a way to meet these divinely imparted deepest needs in each other. He wants you to discover depths of delight that could come only from the hand of a gracious God. Today, Heather and Barry, you are embarking on a great journey, much like a seafaring journey. And it will be an experience of mutual discovery and fulfillment that God longs for you to enjoy, that He desires for you to have, and He plans for you to experience. This is a thing of wonder that can only come from a true union of your minds, and your hearts, and your spirits, and your aspirations, and your longings, and your dreams, and your intentions, and your commitments, and your resolves. So, God is joining you both together at these intimate levels by His wedding gift of agape love, an abundant life. He will take all that makes up you, Heather, and all that makes up you, Barry, and fit and bond to all that together into a totally new entity. Your individual qualities will not be lost in this marriage, but they will be merged with new properties and abilities. Your weaknesses will not disappear, but they will be married to the strengths of the other. When you are married, you will discover that each of you are still uniquely yourselves, but together you are something entirely different. One is strong where the other is not. One's strength has become part of the other. You each look at life differently, and your perspectives affect each other. But you are richer and fuller people because you've become one. You will be one. It doesn't always come easily. There are adjustments to be made. Confronting personal weakness requires courage and demands change. But love, agape love, always finds a way. So thank you for allowing me to be in your lives for these past years. Heather, for so many years watching you grow up, it has been an honor. And Barry, less time, but not the less honor. A real pleasure to know you and count you as a friend and brother. And thank you both for allowing me to share in this great moment. I and everyone here owe you a debt of gratitude for giving us so much joy in this celebration. I close by urging you once again to receive from God's Spirit that agape love which can only be given away to each other. Bell is not a bell until you ring it. A song is not a song until you sing it. Love in your heart is not put there to stay. Love isn't love till you give it away. Agape love always gives away, never expecting anything in return, even gratitude. May you both always give love away to each other. And as you do, your home will become a haven where God will be pleased to dwell. Amen. Now, are you ready to make your personal commitments and vows?
Is it me?
I think so.
Barry, I feel so honored to become your wife today. As we begin our own family, I'll always remember our first Halloween party, our first messages about music that made me realize how much I wanted to be with you, and the moment in our first few months when I'd realized I'd never want anyone else. Through our years together, things haven't been easy all the time, but we've trusted each other in our relationship and we've grown stronger. You've always shown me that no matter where life has taken us, near or far, we were always worth it. We've been through everything together, and today and always, I'm yours. I will always be on your side, and I will always believe in us. Every day, we will climb that mountain and share it with you. I love you.
Heather, every time you smile, I feel like all that is good in the world is smiling back at me. Every time that happens, and even every time it doesn't, you make me feel every day like I'm the luckiest person in the world. I knew from when you first told me you liked me, if you remember in my parents' basement that time after the Halloween party. And later, the time you first told me you loved me. With all of your honesty, your warmth, your authenticity, and your heart, I knew that I was in for something good. I vow to do my best to help you feel that same way every day, as I may be lucky enough for you to do the same for me. And I vow to love you with all of my heart. We spend so much time in different parts of the country, but even then, as we are now, we were always together, and we always will be. As Dr. Malcolm said in Jurassic Park, life finds a way, and it has. As Ben Kenny says, I love it when our worlds collide, and as Brandon Boyd in Incubus sang, You're a mountain that I would like to climb, not to conquer, but to share in the view. And I vow to do that now and always. I love you.
I hand you this.
Okay.
To put in your pocket.
Okay, thanks.
Recognizes right answer when told.
Yes.
Good.
I think we're off to a good start.
We're not even done yet.
I believe I know the answer to this, but I now must ask. Heather, do you now solemnly vow to take Barry as your wedded husband? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Well then, repeat after me. I, Heather, take you, Barry.
I, Heather, take you, Barry.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till we are parted by death.
Till we are parted by death.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Barry, do you now solemnly vow to take Heather as your wedded wife? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Then repeat after me. I, Barry, take you, Heather.
I, Barry, take you, Heather.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till we are parted by death.
Till we are parted by death.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
May I have the rings?
Hey guys.
Thank you. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, these rings which we bless in your name, that they who wear them may ever keep true faith with each other, and so, abiding in your peace and in obedience to your will, may live together in love unchanging through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
With this ring, I wed you.
With this ring, I wed you.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
And with you, all my worldly goods I share.
And with you, all my worldly goods I share.
Thank you.
Barry, repeat after me.
Okay.
With this ring, I wed you.
With this ring, I wed you.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
And with you, all my worldly goods I share.
And with you, all my worldly goods I share.
Go ahead.
It's that one, right? Yeah.
Gently.
Actually, the other way around. Gently.
You want me to put it in?
Let us pray. O eternal God, creator and preserver of all people, the author of everlasting life, send your blessing upon this man and this woman, your children, whom we now bless in your name. Give them grace to truly keep the vows they have made here, as symbolized by the rings they now wear. And by your almighty power, may they ever remain in perfect love and peace together, according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You recognize this? God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Therefore, since Heather and Barry have openly and mutually joined in holy wedlock, before this company and in the sight of God, with their solemn vows, by giving and receiving a ring as an ordained and duly appointed minister in the body of Christ, and in obedience to the will of Almighty God, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
May I kiss now?
Bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace, now and forevermore, and unto ages of ages. Amen. It is a true pleasure and immense honor to introduce to you as a married couple for the very first time, Heather and Barry. Yeah.